We're talking about Lourie Coria. You fought Konsakao in a great fight in the past. A lot of people thought you pulled it off, but this weekend, he got the win over Shockey Foster, very controversial. But you want to fight him in a rematch now that he's a champion.
I'll fight him now.
Tell me about that.
Congrats to him. I somebody tagged me, you know, talking smack, saying, oh, Louis beat his ass and all that. I was just like, you know, like, congratulations.
You want all that smoke.
Yeah, I mean.
What do you remember from fighting him?
He threw a lot. He didn't hit hard, but
But you threw a lot, too.
I threw a lot, too, but it was a great fight. It was a great fight. We both did what we needed to do, and they gave him the decision. I don't think that was correct, but oh well.
But you want the smoke.
Yeah. And I mean, now they did it again. I think Foster won.
And what happens when you fight him?
Who? Contesal?
Yeah, in a rematch.
I think maybe the same kind of fight.
Okay. You have a spar Loma?
I haven't.
You have a spar Tank?
I haven't.
What happens if they fight?
That's a very technical fight. That's a very technical fight. I think it's just like a banger win waiting to happen in the middle of the fight, in the middle of the ring, the rounds.
Can you pick a winner?
I want to give it to Loma, but I think probably Tank, just because of his power. I think he's fast. He has great footwork as well, but I think the power is just different on both fighters.
What do you guys think, Tank or Loma?
I think Tank takes it.
Yeah, I think Tank takes
decision
it.
Or knockout?
Knockout.
Late round.
Okay. Crawford, Canelo.
The only thing there is Canelo's physically like bulkier, bigger, stockier. But the technical fight is Crawford.
You like him in a fight?
I would give him a decision. I would give him the decision.
I think Canelo's too big. What do you think?
What was the question?
Canelo, Crawford.
Crawford. Late rounds.
By the way, they look just like Andre Ward's logo.
Yeah.
I thought it was. Everybody says that?
Yeah, everybody said that.
I didn't know people knew Andre Ward's logo.
Yeah.
Okay, so Shakur, what does he do next? If you're Shakur, where are you going?
To be honest, I don't know. I think he just has to go where he's going to get the big fights, because I think Shakur's one of the best. And I think he just needs to prove himself with the biggest fights.
I think maybe he should take a little bit of time off to look at his decisions, you know, his choices, options, and just think about it. I'm sure the opportunity will present itself.
A lot of people are criticizing him, but at the end of the day, he won his fight. He made millions, so how can you lose, right?
Exactly. At the end of the day, it's a business, right?
You get paid, and you got the W.
Exactly.
And you can't please everybody.
Exactly.
But if he and Tank fight, who wins?
Shakur and Tank?
I think Tank too.
Why do you guys say that?
Tank's more of a physical fighter. Tank will come forward, walk him down.
I think the natural strength and power.
He's been destroying everybody.
Okay, so what did you guys think about Zapata knocking out that kid from Wild Card? What's his name?
Cabrera.
Yeah.
I thought that's how the fight was gonna go. I didn't think it was gonna happen that soon, but I predicted it that way.
Yeah, me too. You know, He's a great kid, but he has a weird style, and it's not an
awkward, no power, yeah, seven knockouts.
Yeah. Yeah.
And I think the output Zapata has, it's very, very hard to defend that.
Yeah.
And another one I want to ask you guys. So right now, pound for pound, who's the pound for pound and who's the face of boxing?
Bam.
Bam's pound for pound king?
Bam.
Number one fighter in the world? And who's the face of boxing?
I can give it to Tank first and then Bam.
So Tank pound for pound, then Bam.
Yeah.
Okay. Everybody tells me wherever I go that Tank's the pound for pound king.
I would say Tank, Bam, in a way.
Yeah.
I'm gonna tell you guys what's funny. Introduce yourself really quick.
My name is Abel Mejia.
And what's your record?
My 4-0, 3 KOs.
I'm his dad.
Nah, I know.
Drew Mejia.
Louis here.
Louis, what's your record now? You have a lot of fights already.
I don't know. I got 23 fights.
23. Okay. Yeah. Everywhere I go, fighters. Everywhere I go, it doesn't matter. I travel all over the United States. Tank is pound for pound king.
Yeah.
But if you look on social media, all the reporters are such haters. They barely put him top 8, top 10. Oh, you shouldn't be on the list. Why is it that professional fighters from all over the world say that Tank is the pound for pound king, but the reporters refuse to see his greatness? 30-0, 28 knockouts against everybody. 3-division champ.
I don't know. Everybody has their choice of fighter that they like and things like that.
Yeah, but fighters see it different. Yeah, trainers see it different than the media. True. Media never box, and they go by who pays them or who who's good for business for them. Nice. If I put you on my list, maybe the promoter will give me a hotel room or flight or maybe give me access.
Yeah, also, if you think about it, like the mainstream media is a clean image, right? Tank doesn't really have that clean image that, you know, that can represent.
But he could fight.
Yeah, definitely.
Oh, I see what you're saying. Tank's a great person. I've been around him for many years. Yeah. He's a big heart. He always nice to everybody, does charity. He did a whole turkey giveaway or for the homeless, whatever, jackets. But you won't see one picture or video. Some people do charity stuff, Louis. Just look at me. I'm giving the homeless a blanket. Like Haney records himself giving them money. Don't do that. Yeah. If you're going to do something, Kobe Bryant did a lot for the homeless. You won't see one video or picture.
I mean, obviously, if like an outsider sees Abel passing out backpacks to kids, and it's like, oh, you know.
No, but that's different. I'm saying you're pulling up in a corner. I've been with Broner 2 a.m. and we're in Kansas, or I forgot what state, but we're out there. He says, Ellie, turn off your camera. Rolls down the window, gives each homeless like $100. He didn't want it on camera. He just wanted to do it because he's a good dude.
Yeah.
Other people would be like, hey, take out your camera and make sure you give me my good angle. Cambosis will post that picture if he gives you homeless the blankets. And the homeless looks so embarrassed at that moment.
Yeah, it just takes away the credibility.
Right, it just looks like cheap, cheesy marketing. But I'm saying it's definitely interesting to me that all the fighters that I interview from all over the world, pound for pound, Tank. Face of boxing, Tank or Canelo. That's how they say it. But for the media, it's they'll pick whoever they fit their agenda.
Very, very biased.
I think Tank has fought better and more bigger opponents than Canelo. I think Canelo just picks and chooses, obviously, who he wants. And I don't think they have a big enough name. I think Tank's done more than
Canelo.
And you
know what, too? And if you look at Tank's fights, it's the way he beats them. You know what I mean? I mean, he destroys them.
You make a mistake. One mistake. Leo threw 3 punches, like, thought that he had was winning. And it's everybody, like, he calculates, he picks it. Barrios, people thought, although he was up on the judges' cards, Mayweather told him, you're not on, and he knocked him out. And Barrios was 26-0, now Barrios is a champ.
Yeah, and the Ryan Garcia fight, if you think about it, Ryan is a bigger fighter, you know what I mean?
Physically, and that hook is vicious.
Exactly.
Tank went under it, and...
Exactly.
But not only that, but you look at when he won the title, I think he only had 15 fights, 16 fights. He was the youngest champion at the time. Pedraza was undefeated. So it's people like to pick and choose and say, who has he fought? But then when I ask them, who's your favorite fighter and who did they fight? It's not, they don't even have that.
It doesn't match up, yeah.
So, hey, look, all right.
I need a pose, bro.
Hold on one more.
There you go.
Reporting, all right, tell people where to follow you.
KingLouis416 on IG.
On Instagram, Abel_Damajia.
And when is your next fight?
July 26th at the Commerce Casino.
Let's go. Who's the promoter?
Tom Lothar, 360 Promotions.
Okay.
Drew_Mejia_
All right, make sure to follow him. Stay tuned. Representing Santa Ana?
Yes, sir. Well, sir. Orange County.
Orange County. I was just there for Nate Diaz's fight. It was lit. It was at the Honda Center. You know, they sold out.
We saw you like 4 times. We shook your hand like 4 times.
You know what? Can I tell you how many people I saw?
Yeah.
I was joking that I want to hire a film crew to follow me around at these events.
Because
I probably took 1,000 pictures. I don't remember who I saw, but it happens every event, but nobody believes me.
Yeah.
There was a movie called Along Came Polly.
No, actually, no.
You seen that one? And he has a friend that used to be an actor in the movie, and he says they're doing an Eat True Hollywood style. And he hired people to follow him like he has a show. That's what I need to do, Louis. Yeah. Hire people and say they were CNN. Yeah. So there you have it. Stay tuned. Ellie Stickback reporting.